Hello, this is Atubo George and compliments of the season. Now, this is Christmas week. Praise God. Now, it's so beautiful. Listen, why we celebrate Christmas is because of Jesus. And without Jesus, there wouldn't have been any Christmas. Now, don't start arguing whether Jesus was born on the 25th of December. There are some of us who our parents don't even know the day they were born, but we still celebrate their birthdays. Praise God. So we celebrate Jesus. The truth is Jesus came, and that's why we celebrate him. He was born into this world. Praise God. Now, this week, I'm going to be sharing with you what the Lord have laid in my heart to share with you this week. And that's what I titled, Why Did Jesus Come? Praise God. I'm going to be sharing with you 5 reasons Jesus came, and every day we'll take one reason, one of it. Praise God. Now I just pray that the Spirit of God will help us and give you understanding. Now, the first, number one, Jesus came to reveal the Father to us. See, Jesus came to reveal the Father to us. Now let me show you something in the book of Matthew chapter 11. Matthew 11 and verse 27. Now here it says, all things, Jesus speaking now, and it says, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Did you see that? So who reveals the Father? It's the Son. That Son is Jesus. It is Jesus that reveals the Father to us. Now that's very instructive. You remember in John chapter 14, Jesus was talking to his disciples and Philip said something. Philip said something. He says, show us the Father and it's going to be fine with us. And Jesus said, hey, have you been so long with me and yet you have not known the Father? And then he says, he that have seen me have seen the Father. So how come you're saying, show us the Father? Now, why is it important that Jesus had to come to reveal who the Father is? Now, because right from the beginning, the Father have been misunderstood. You see, everyone came, and you know how it is. See, some time ago, I shared with you on false teachings. And I told you false teachings not because the intent was to do wrong or to be false. No, it's just, you know, how we fake things that is not complete. How we take half-truth and run with it without waiting for the full manifestation of the truth. So Moses came, and he says, okay, of all the things Moses got from God, he says, okay, you know what? Let me summarize it by making some laws. And he says, thou shalt not. And he said a lot of things. But Jesus came, and Jesus began to teach the people. And part of the things he began to do was to set straight the things that Moses said. You know, he would say, oh, Moses said an eye for an eye. But listen, I say to you. See, now he was bringing or revealing the heart of the Father to us. And what is that? God is love. Praise God. Now, many folks didn't know that God is love. They just said, oh, God is just there waiting for us to make a mistake so he'll deal with us. God is just there setting, he has said everything. He's just waiting for us to, so that he can judge us. No. Jesus, remember the woman brought to Jesus that was caught in the act of adultery. What did Jesus do? He rescued her. See, now that's the heart of God. He is not just there, he wants to punish you. No, he is looking for ways to rescue you. That's God. Praise God. Now, if Jesus hadn't come, we wouldn't have known that's who God is. But you see, because Jesus is the express image of the Father. Jesus, like he said to Philip, he that have seen me have seen the Father. Did you get that? Meaning, everything you see me do is just exactly what the Father would do. Jesus actually said, he says, I do not speak of my own self, but as I hear, that's what I do. And Jesus actually said, look, everything I do, remember, he says, my Father has not left me alone, The reason is because I do always those things that please him. So today I want you to know this. The reason Jesus came is because he wanted to show us who the Father is. You remember in John chapter 1, he says, no man has seen the Father at any time. See? But what did Jesus come to do? He came to reveal him. He came to manifest him. Not just by saying, this is who the Father is. But you see, by coming to show in display the character, the nature, the whatever you call it, whatever attribute the Father has, Jesus came to reveal it. Praise God. Now, when you study the words of Jesus, and that's one thing I always encourage people to do, take your Bible. You can just take a red letter edition and read everything in red. Just read everything in red. Praise God. You know, from Matthew to John, just read everything in red. And you are going to see something that you may never have seen before. Because many times, like I told you earlier, false teachings have done a lot of harm. It have given us a false representation of who the Father is. But that's why Jesus came. So when you embrace Jesus, you are embracing the Father's will. When you embrace the words of Jesus, you are embracing the Father's words. Praise God. I've got to stop here today. But tomorrow, I'm going to tell you the next reason Jesus came. Have a wonderful day today. And share love in this season. God bless you. Bye-bye.